It can be a wild and inhospitable place to call home.
The solar panels are up all the way.
My mother lives with us.
And that she needs extraordinary levels of heat.
In this remote area of Montana, roads can be closed for months at a time during winter, and isolation can be a real problem. So why would anyone choose to live here? Well, this is why. The peaceful tranquility of life beside Lake Kokanoosa in northern Montana. It drew Tim and Cathy Schwartz to relocate here just under 2 years ago, and it's a decision neither of them regret.
Both my wife and I love not having neighbors, and we just wanted some real quiet space that we could live in. Coming down the road was really wonderful because it felt like you were dropping into the woods. The breeze through the trees and the open sky and the open space, and that it was surrounded by a national forest. It just seemed ideal for retirement.
But the reality of starting from scratch in such a remote corner of the state and with zero amenities was not something the couple took on lightly.
There's no power, no water. There are a couple water tanks, an outdoor toilet facility, and two cabins that were not joined together. And they had no facilities whatsoever except a wood stove inside.
Despite the clear challenges of the location, Tim and Cathy could see its potential and how they could turn it into their dream retirement home in the woods.
We've been married for 40, almost 50 years. It's given Tim and I a chance to work together. Part of the reason we chose this was because it was two cabins that we could quickly join together so that we could have the full family here.
Well, this is the access to the back part of the property and underneath the house. We had to repair all this.
A big step towards realizing that dream was Tim's desire to find the best system possible to support their new life out here. A search that led him to Victron Energy.
So yeah, this was all dirt and rock in between the two cabins. And so we built in the floor.
Well, we knew we needed electricity just for small appliances and lighting and anything we wanted to do, really. So I had read a lot about solar energy and even hydro energy and all kinds of energy sources, and so the first thing we thought we would do would be the solar. A gentleman by the name of Aaron Hansen was recommended to us up in Missoula, Montana, with Intelligent Controls, and he provided the know-how and the ability to put the system together for us so that we could install it ourselves. You put all the control units, the components together on a board and made sure everything was working together nicely. Then we went down and picked up the board actually and brought it back and figured out where to mount it and put it in order to attach the cables from the panels on the roof. And then from the cables from the board to the fuse panel.
You have a very standard off-grid system with a whole standard off-grid story. And the story is piece of property in the middle of nowhere or far enough from the power grid that I can afford it, that's a good deal. It's a place that I actually want to live, but I don't have power. What do I do? And how do I live there with my mother-in-law and my, you know, kids and everything else? And how do I make it just a normal experience? So the whole system has evolved and developed, and he's done all the work. We pre-programmed some stuff for him and put it on a board. But in general, he's reconfigured everything and redone a lot of the equipment himself.
Tim's Victron system comprises of an 8 kVA quattro inverter charger, a 6 stack of US 3000C Pylontech batteries totaling 21.3 kilowatt hours, a Serbo GX and screen, along with a 450 volt 100 amp MPPT RS charger. Like many American homes, Tim has a split phase system. Most household sockets are 120 volts, but large appliances such as ovens and washer dryers often use 240 volts. The Quattro is a 240 volt version, but he uses an auto transformer to drop the voltage down to supply the 120 volt circuits. The system is charged by solar panels on the roof of the main cabin, along with a generator for backup. It's a setup that's been so reliable, they've not had to sacrifice anything so far in terms of energy consumption.
We've been using it for at least 6 months, with absolutely not a hitch. So the whole system works very well and has supplied power for us ever since the day we connected everything. Biggest thing that we wanted power for, of course, was the submersible pump in the rain tank. And to power that with any other electronic devices that we needed to serve food or watch TV, listen to music, and run any kind of small tools, machinery that I needed to be able to work on the cabins and make them livable. It's worked incredibly well. It's beyond our expectations, and I am so glad that we went through that setup.
Another consideration when planning his system was Tim's mother-in-law, Nancy, who lives with them on the property and who, on her first visit to the site, was concerned they'd bitten off more than they could chew.
Total shock. I'm here because I need to be with my daughter and son-in-law, and they love the place from the minute they saw it, but in my whole life I have never lived without, you know, all the running water and the facilities. I've had lovely homes, and so this was quite a shock.
But thanks to Tim's careful planning and installation of the Victron system, things have become a lot more comfortable.
We had nothing, literally. Two separate cabins, no water, no nothing, a toilet out in a pink house. And so now we have hot and cold running water, electricity. The cabins are joined. We have an indoor bathroom. You know, how much different could it be? 100%.
Nancy's a very active and independent woman, enjoying life in her own cabin. And thanks to the Victron system, is able to stay connected with friends in the outside world and indulge in one of her great passions.
I'm a bridge player, and I've almost achieved the rating of Ruby Life Master. So it keeps me connected. I play with my friends from Prescott, Arizona, California. I can play with anybody all over the world. So I get to play the game that I really like a lot. Also, through the email, I can order clothes. I can order pharmaceutical things. And so it connects me with the world. And like I told you, I buy my puzzles online. Do an awful lot of online. And yes, they do deliver.
There's no anxiety about what we can run and can't run. My mom has her recliner. She can't sleep in a bed. And so if it can't go up or down, she's stuck. And so it's important to have some power and not being anxious about it. So since it's been in, we're doing well with that. It's awesome.
Tim may have been a novice at planning and designing an off-grid system, robust enough to provide for his wife and mother-in-law, but he's confident enough now to investigate expanding his setup to cater for visits from other family members.
Additional structures we have planned, and shop and some cabins for our grandchildren, so they can come and visit at will and be comfortable. We are looking to add panels and devices where necessary to make it just more untouchable, reliable, without constant maintenance. And so we're attaching a whole house generator and more panels as we, you know, finish off aspects of the building so that they will be easily incorporated.
As Tim, Cathy, and Nancy look forward to welcoming the rest of their family to the wilds of northern Montana, they can now look on with pride at all they've achieved with this idyllic lakeside build and immerse themselves in the nature and magic of their new surroundings.
We love watching the sky. We love being outside when it rains, thinking about how it's filling up the cistern. And we enjoy the sound of rain, always have. And then the change in the clouds, the change in the sky, and the way the trees move, and the water around us, it's just really enjoyable. Very soothing, very therapeutic in all ways.
If you'd like to learn more about living off-grid, as Tim, Cathy, and Nancy do, check out our page on the Victron Energy website, dedicated to backup and off-grid systems. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. It doesn't cost anything. And if you click the bell icon, you'll be notified about our next video.